Solitary fibrous tumours are fibroblastic and most were previously diagnosed as hemangiopericytomas. Solitary fibrous tumours arise in many sites including pleura, mediastinum, respiratory tract, subcutaneous tissue, head and neck including salivary glands, sinuses, orbit and meninges, also the retroperitoneum, gastrointestinal tract, liver, bladder, prostate, kidney, etc. Around 85 to 90% of solitary fibrous tumours have benign behaviour. They tend to arise between the ages of 20 and 70 with a median age of 50 years and affect males and females pretty much equally. Grossly, they are well circumscribed, measuring between 1 and 25 centimetres across. The cellularity is variable with bland spindle cells and also myxoid areas. The tumour cells show positive staining with CD34 in over 90% of cases, and keloid-like foci may be found. A fairly distinctive feature is the presence of staghorn-like or staghorn-shaped blood vessels with perivascular hyalinisation, and mast cells are often present. There may be mitotic activity, but this is less than 3 mitotic figures per 10 high-power fields in the solitary fibrous tumours that are likely to have benign behaviour. Features of malignancy in solitary fibrous tumours include hypercellularity, increased mitotic activity, that is over 4 mitotic figures per 10 high-power fields, areas of necrosis and infiltrative borders. This is a nice gross example of a solitary fibrous tumour. This one arose on the vas deferens. And this is a low power view of a solitary fibrous tumour, and you can see how well circumscribed it is with a very sharp boundary between the tumour and adjacent tissue. This is a blood vessel showing a thin rim of perivascular hyalinisation. This is a myxoid area. This area of the solitary fibrous tumour is highly cellular. Here is an area of hyalinisation. And scattered throughout solitary fibrous tumours, mast cells may be found. And these are the cells with the rather granular bluish staining cytoplasm. And here is a staghorn-shaped blood vessel.